Hello everyone, welcome back to ABS Boys. This is Trisha Sharma, your host for today. So our today's video is on a very exciting topic, where we'll discuss the A320 glass cockpit basically with the help of a 360 degree view. So here we go. Wait, so before proceeding further, let's discuss what changes technology has brought from our old generation to latest generation airplanes. The previous aircraft used to have analog instruments where different flight parameters were represented with the help of different gauges, dials that gave the data in terms of readings, which were mechanically transmitted and physically read by the movement of needles. But in glass cockpit use now, the cockpit features electronic flight instrument displays, typically large LCD screens, rather than the traditional style of analog dials and gauges. Also guys, if you like our videos for any reason, all you have to do is support us, and that you can do is by clicking on the subscribe red button given on the right hand side down. So as soon as we enter the cockpit, we see here 6 LCD units, 2 side sticks, no control column, 2 electrically and manually controlled pilot seats, EFIS, electronic flight instrument system that consists of PFD and ND, ECAM, electronic centralized aircraft monitoring system, ISIS, integrated standby instrument system, FCU, overhead panel, and the control panel that is also known as central pedestal panel. So further, when you see right behind the seat of the pilot, you'll see a wall full of CBs, that is circuit breakers that refer to different electrical connections within the cockpit for different aircraft systems. Basically, it serves an important purpose while troubleshooting a snag that has been reported by flight crew or being checked during routine maintenance. Moving on further inside the cockpit, you will see there are 6 bright LCD displays, all of them serving different purposes. On to your left hand side, you will see PFD and ND. Primary flight display and the navigation display serve one of the most important purposes, that's why they are duplicated LCD screens individually for both captain and first officer. The PFD and ND serve different purposes. PFD provides different parameters, whereas ND provides navigation. Onto the center, you see these two displays are known as ECAM, electronic centralized aircraft monitoring system, upper ECAM as well as the lower ECAM. So when you zoom in, just right beside the ECAM display, you can see landing gear position indicators. Behind them is the auto brake sector, below is the watch, and below them you can see landing gear control levers, and onto the right hand side is the triple indicator. Now moving on to the central pedestal panel, in the middle is the ECAM control panel, from where you can select different ECAM pages like APU, wheel, oxygen, hydraulic, fuel, and so on. Onto the both sides of ECAM control panel is the MCDU, that stands for Multifunctional Control and Display Unit, that is used to input various types of data into the computer, that is FMGC. We'll talk about that in our later videos. So MCDU works in conjunction with the FMGC, Flight Management and Guidance Computer. Along with the frequency control panels given on both sides individually for first officer and captain, there are different control panels for controlling and selecting different frequencies for communicating with the respective authority. Now coming back again to the central pedestal panel, you will spot here two throttle levers mounted in center with two pitch trim wheels on either sides for setting the course for THS. THS stands for Trimmable Horizontal Stabilizer. Below this comes the engine master switches and the ignition control switch with white color right in the center. Below it are two black colored levers. These levers are used for controlling flight control surfaces, the left one for spoilers and the right one for flaps. So coming downwards on the central pedestal panel, between these two black levers, we'll spot a white color rotary selector known as rudder trim selector. and alongside is the indicator that displays this reading digitally and can also be reset with the help of the reset button given alongside. Moving downwards, you will see a parking brake selector switch that can be pulled up and turned either left or right in order to activate and deactivate the parking brake. Currently, the parking brake is set to on. On to the right hand side of the parking brake is the ACRS printer, aircraft condition and address reporting system. All the way down, you will see this red lever saying gravity gear extension, pull and turn. This is the emergency gear extension lever that is used in the event when all of the systems of the aircraft fail that are able to extend the landing gear. Now coming back to the control levers, you will see the side stick with the red button mounted on it that can be used for autopilot disconnection as well as for gaining the side stick priority also. And onto the left hand side of the side stick, you will see a small controller. This is known as tiller, that is used to basically steer the nose wheel when the aircraft is steered on ground during taxiing. And as soon as the speed of the aircraft increases, the steering angle of the nose wheel goes on decreasing. So here we spot the side stick priority indicator that indicates that who holds the priority of the side stick, whether captain or the first officer. So as in very rare options, surprisingly, you can also spot an head-up display in an Airbus A320 that helps the pilot monitor vital information just in his line of sight. And as a very surprising matter of fact, you can also spot a compass right here in the center. Comment down below if you knew this. So now let's move on to one of the most interesting part of the entire cockpit that I personally love is the overhead panel. That is a completely fascinating thing to observe on an Airbus aircraft. So it has been distributed into different sections according to the aircraft's operation. As you can see here, the first one at the top is the fire panel where you get the engine discharge buttons for APU and engine number 1 and engine number 2 fires. So right below it, you can see the hydraulic panel which indicates the green, blue and the yellow systems and the different primary sources of pressure on those systems. Below it is the fuel system where you can spot engine number 1, engine number 2 and fuel, and whereas different pumps situated in the fuel system as well as the cross feed. Below it is the electrical panel of the overhead complete control panel which indicates the different sources of power, batteries, BAT1, BAT2, serial buses, AC generator 1, AC generator 2 mounted on respective engine number 1 and engine number 2. Coming down, you can spot air conditioning panel which has different control levers for controlling the amount of airflow, or you can also select the amount of the temperature, cold to hot, depending on the different region of the aircraft, from cockpit to forward cabin, aft cabin and pack flow. And also it indicates the different sources from which the air is coming, engine number 1 bleed or engine number 2 bleed. Below it are different switches that have their particular operation, like anti-icing and different switches for different external lights of aircraft. Another very cool and yet a very unique thing on an Airbus aircraft is this clipped corner side window that helps you in identifying whether the aircraft is in Boeing or in Airbus. The cockpit totally comprises of 6 windows, 2 on each side and 2 on the center, in which 2 windows are retractable while all of them are fixed windows. So this was it for today guys. This was a complete 360 degree tour of the basic instrument that you can spot on an Airbus aircraft. This was basically done in order to get you a little familiarization about all the instruments and whatever you see in an Airbus aircraft. So this was it for today guys. Hope you liked the video. I'll keep bringing this type of stuff on my channel. Thank you for watching and making us a part of your family. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you next time.